A short overview of economic inequality, explained by the Citizen Genius Project. Instead of there being a perfectly equal distribution, economic inequality means there is a gap between the rich and poor, whether that means there is a small gap or a large gap. This video will focus on economic inequality in terms of income and wealth, but economic inequality could also refer to some other way of measuring the economy. Before examining the amount of economic inequality around the world and in the United States, let's examine the difference between income and wealth. Income refers to money that is received from a salary, wage, tip, gift, interest earned on an investment, or another source. Wealth refers to the value of assets minus liabilities, meaning having things of value minus any debts. Wealth can include property like a house, car, artwork, and jewelry, as well as savings, a pension or retirement account, an investment like owning stocks or bonds, or something else of value. Now let's examine some data showing the degree of economic inequality in the world and in the US. Let's look at the world first. In terms of income, a Gallup survey that gathered data from 2006 through 2012 found that the world's median household income was $9,733. The country with the largest median household income was Luxembourg, with $52,493 per household, while the country with the lowest amount was Burundi, with a median household income of just $673. Now let's check out the degree of wealth inequality in the world. A recent report analyzed the wealth distribution among the world's approximately 7.4 billion people and found that the 8 wealthiest people in the world have the same amount of wealth as the poorest half of the world's population. In other words, the 8 at the top equal the 3.7 billion at the bottom. A different study from 2015 found that the wealthiest 0.7% held at least $1 million of wealth each and made up 45.2% of the world's total wealth, while the bottom 71% held less than $10,000 of wealth each and combined for just 3% of the world's total wealth. Inequality can also be seen within countries. This map shows each country's degree of inequality as measured by the Gini coefficient. The darkest red color indicates countries with the highest degree of inequality, while the light yellow color indicates countries that have the highest degree of equality. Now let's examine inequality within the US, starting with income inequality. In 2013, the top 1% of income earners made an average of nearly $1.7 million, while the bottom 40% earned an average of $20,300. Similarly, a different study found that in 2014, the top 1% accounted for 21.2% of total US income, while the bottom 99% shared 78.8% of the income. As of 2015, the CEO of a large US company made 335 times what a worker got paid. In terms of wealth, the Congressional Budget Office found that in 2013, the amount of wealth families held was distributed such that the top 10% of families owned 76% of the wealth, the middle to 90% range owned 23% of the wealth, and the bottom half of families combined for just 1% of the wealth. The top 1% of households specifically owned 36.7% of the wealth. Based on the aforementioned data, it is clear that there is a high degree of economic inequality in both the world and the US. By looking at the US through a historical perspective, we can see that the degree of inequality has not always been so high. The distribution of income or wealth can change over time to create more or less inequality. It's important to note that at any given moment in time, there is only so much income to be earned or wealth to be had. So the reason why some people have less is because other people have more. In other words, the more some have, the less others can have. Economic growth is often presented as a way to reduce inequality. However, growth will not necessarily do so. Changing social values and/or government policies can have a significant impact on the growth or reduction of inequality. Whether or not economic inequality should be reduced is debatable. Those who want to maintain the current level of inequality argue that inequality provides an incentive to work hard. while those who want to reduce inequality argue that a high degree of inequality creates economic, social, and political problems. These are topics that can be more fully explored in other videos.